NAC, or N-acetylcysteine, is an amino acid that helps the body create and use protective antioxidants, along with two other amino acids, glutamine and glycine. NAC is necessary to make and replenish glutathione, and while NAC is considered conditionally essential because your body can produce it from other amino acids, it really only becomes essential when the dietary intake of methionine and serine is low. So in this video, I wanted to talk about what NAC is, why it's beneficial, and whether or not you need to take an NAC supplement. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Now, there isn't a daily requirement of NAC that you must be getting from your diet, but getting higher amounts may benefit some people, and while you can find cysteine, which is a sulfur-containing amino acid in foods like chicken, turkey, garlic, and eggs, NAC is found only in supplements or medicine. And what you might not have known is that it's been used for about 3 decades now as a mucolytic agent for respiratory conditions, as it works great to loosen thick mucus in pneumonia and bronchitis, but also it has been used for reversing acetaminophen toxicity. But nowadays, people take it to reduce inflammation, insulin resistance, infertility due to PCOS, and much more. But how does NAC work is the real question. Well, it's all about turning on what's called the mother of all antioxidants, or the master antioxidant, glutathione. Glutathione helps make DNA, helps break down nutrients, regulates our immune responses, and protects against oxidative stress. In the body, NAC converts to L-cysteine, a non-essential amino acid, but then the body uses L-cysteine to make more glutathione, which is a tripeptide or chain of amino acids, cysteine, glycine, and glutamic acid. And because of the long list of use cases NAC has, we're going to have to look at our Journal of Antioxidants on NAC, which I'll link down below to see what we find. Here's a diagram of the mechanism of action that breaks it down quite nicely, actually. You have direct and indirect antioxidant action, disulfide breaking activity, and anti-inflammatory properties. And here you can clearly read the importance of NAC as a potent antioxidant is directly linked to its ability to increase levels of intracellular cysteine, with subsequent increases in glutathione. And instead of going through each of the conditions it is said to play a role in, this diagram sums up the biological activities and therapeutics of NAC, so you can pause the video if you wanted to take some notes. Let me know which conditions you're actually the most interested in, but what I did want to point out is a separate study made on insulin and PCOS that I found fascinating. It's the one from 2017 titled A Review on Various Uses of N-acetylcysteine. It's sectioned on PCOS when they use CC or clomiphene citrate for the induction of ovulation in PCOS women. Recent studies have shown that a combination of CC and NAC considerably increased both ovulation and pregnancy rates in women with CC-resistant PCOS, and that treatment of hyperinsulinemic patients by NAC was found to tailor control parameters of glucose in them, and consequently their insulin levels and peripheral insulin sensitivity were reduced and increased respectively. Therefore, the antioxidant effects of NAC may act as a therapeutic approach to improve the level of circulating insulin, as well as insulin sensitivity in PCOS patients with hyperinsulinemia, which again is very interesting. Now, when it comes to dosing, a common dose of NAC is anywhere from 600 to 1200 milligrams per day. You'll find strengths of 500, 600, 750, and 1000 milligrams. However, it's important to discuss with your doctor to see if you are a right candidate for NAC and to get the precise dose that may be better suited for you. There's some debate whether or not it might be safe for people with asthma, bleeding problems, and or anyone taking nitroglycerin, including blood thinners and certain blood pressure medicines. If these apply to you, then you definitely want to check in with your doctor first before using NAC supplements. But if you're looking for one on the market, make sure it's from a reputable company that does third-party testing for purity and quality. I've left below a few that you can check out in the description below. Not sponsored, but the one by Thorne is a favorite of mine, as their mission is to always provide high-quality supplements that are tested for quality, safety, and efficacy. And another important factor to consider that is often missed is the fact that you got two types of glutathione and their specific enzymes. You got reduced glutathione and oxidized glutathione. Glutathione peroxidase triggers a reaction of glutathione to oxidize glutathione, which is when the glutathione takes the hit, takes the damage to protect the cell, basically. Then you have glutathione reductase, which then triggers the conversion of oxidized glutathione that we just mentioned back to usable glutathione. This is known as glutathione recycling, and there are about five nutritional compounds that support glutathione recycling pathways: L-glutamine, selenium, cordyceps, goat's cola, and milk thistle, which also increases superoxide dismutase. And now that Amazon was able to relist NAC products as of August of last year, many wonder if it's even worth taking now. Personally, if you're presumably already healthy, it is unlikely to have a deficiency in the production of glutathione. You can make an argument, though, if you have a poor diet or have increased biological needs from, let's say, recovery from exercise, since people who exercise vigorously create oxidative free radicals, right, which can lead to muscle fatigue and decreased muscle performance. You can make an argument there, but again, this is one of those cases where you have to be the judge and weigh the pros and cons against your own goals, health history, and personal food philosophy. Click the video here that looks at the top three best turmeric curcumin supplements, which I have a feeling that you'll enjoy as well and learn a lot from. And comment down below what your thoughts are on NAC. We'd love to hear your feedback. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.